Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I am going to show you how to do a one bead nail extension in acrylic, but also we are going to do a bow and it's going to have two chunky, delicious loops on it. You thought I was talking about cake then or something, didn't you?
Yeah, I could smash a piece of cake.
Right? Yeah. So JJ's already got a nail prepped. So basically what we're going to do is create this. One bead. I'm going to show you how. Lots of people ask me about one bead application. This video is a two for one. We do like a two for one video. So I'm going to fit the form.
This is my dodgy finger. I've got no strength in this finger whatsoever.
Has this finger not been to the finger gym?
No.
Jay, why has it not been to the finger gym?
Right, go like that.
Yeah, my knuckles have to be up, don't they?
But where that one can go like that. Yeah, now do it with that. Yeah. You got less move. You can't move that one.
Oh, look, my little finger goes. Look at that. Oh.
So if you try to keep him still, now do it.
See? Oh. It's all a bit weird. Right, gonna dehydrate. Maybe I need to exercise it more.
I think it's something to do with them. Tenderness things.
Tenderness things.
Tendinums.
Tendinums. I'm going to prime. Acid-free primer. And we're going to use Rose Glow. It's a gorgeous colour, this is. I'm going to go low into the powder to pick up a nice big bead. Straight on. Tap that down, tip the finger down, and then you're going to push and press that big bead all the way down the nail. So once you've smoothed it, you know, you've smoothed it all out, you've got that bead fully on there, you're going to let it set up a little bit, and then we will pinch the nail when it's ready. So I'm going to test pinch with my thumbs, so I've got even pressure, and we're just still a little bit sticky, so give that a second or two. Just test pinching first. Now I'm going to let the pinching tool do its thing. It's going to bring that in and give it a soft curve. Then I'm going to pinch down the length of the nail. Now, one bead application is perfect for salon speed because a lot of people come in the salon and just want an extension and then a one colour gel polish over the top, maybe with a little bit of bling. So yeah, it's so easy to do and it's something that's a skill to learn, but you can definitely do it and it'll increase your quickness in the salon. So that's set. I'm going to take off the form. I'm going to file the nail, in my normal filing routine. My normal filing routine. My normal filing routine. Which is the sidewalls first. And around the cuticle. And then we do the free edge. And then we contour the top. Oh yes, we contour the top.
Over the top.
I'm just going to clean over with some acetone. Over this, I'm going to put this gorgeous colour. We will link it in the description box. So it's going to add a gorgeous pinky purple hue. Beautiful. Pop that into the lamp for me. Beautiful. So we're going to, that's a lovely base to work on as well. We've got a shiny surface, so everything will sit on there nice and neat. Plus, if we're making mistakes with the 3D, we can slide it off as well, which is great. I'm going to use Fairy Godmother. Bibbidi bobbidi boo. I love this colour. Absolutely love it. It's so gorgeous because it's so shimmery. What we're going to do is we're going to do a bow that's got two sets of loops. So actually it's got four loops. And the first set of loops, we're going to do a shape like that. A little bit smaller than that, though.
Yeah, I've got
that. I've just thought, you've got to get your scissors in and you've got to. Yeah. So, I think we're going to go. Your finger. So you can see this indentation that I have on here now. So you've got markers to work with there. So this is a more chunkier bow than we normally do. Well, than I normally do. It's more like what I'd call a Japanese bow. A lot of Japanese nail techs do their bows like this. So I've done exactly the same here with this one. And by the time you've got this one into shape, it's now going to be the point that you're going to lift this up, fold it over, make it meet, and then you're going to bring these sides in a little bit. These are going to be your bottom loops. Ooh, bottom loops.
Oh my god, how old are you? 10?
It's a bit like Carry On, that was, wasn't it? Right, give me your hand. Glass rose. You can use clear as well. I like glass rose at the minute. Have a bit of a thing. Me and glass rose have a bit of a thing going on. I'm going to pop that there, use it as a glue, pick this up, pop that there, so you're not going right to the cuticle. So those are the bottom bows, loops. So yeah, you've had to keep room here for the other loops. Very important. I'm going to put a little bit of glass rose underneath these loops here so they sit a little bit more flush to the nail and they're also secure. You don't want them to stick out too much. You want them to, you still want them to be chunky, so they're really stable, but you want them to curve to the shape of the nail. Now for the top loop, we're going to do this a little bit different. So I'm going to draw on the back of here. I'm just going to use this dotting tool to do it. So we look at how wide JJ's nail is at the back of there. You see how wide it is? So that's how wide. So now we're going to do it twice as wide as that. That's the kind of length that we need, because we're going to fold in. We're going to do a different shape, more like a bikini top kind of shape. So you can see how that one is as wide as that nail that we marked out. That will be folded. So in theory, when they're both folded, they'll be as wide as the nail we're putting out. Once it starts to set up, I'm going to fold it over, let it meet just shy of the middle, fold in and in. Keep all this open.
It looks like a snake's head there. From this angle.
Oh yeah, it does, doesn't it? Well, it looks like a fish now. It's like a fish. Fish. Here, fishy, fishy. So we're folding it just shy of the middle. And again, folding in. Fold it in. Make sure these stay nice and wide. Gonna get some glass rose. Pop that where we want this to go. This is gonna be the glue. So this will basically adhere everything on. We're gonna pick it up like this, and we're gonna pop the side that was stuck to the backing paper. We're gonna pop that on there. Oh, it looks gorgeous already. It looks like a present.
Wow.
And then we're going to do the centre. Now, the centre, we want a nice chunky. We want it to be chunky, so it's going to wrap over. It's going to wrap from here to here. So it's going to be a similar shape to this one we did earlier. This Japanese style of a bow is always quite chunky, which I think gives it that cute look. So you'll see it's not like this bow that I've done on here. This is a slightly different bow. It's more refined. It's got a tighter centre. I'm going to put a little bit of glass rose there. I'm going to pick this up. Roll it off my brush. Secure it down here. And here. And then you need to bend it. Fold it. So it looks like it's wrapping around. One thing I am going to do is make this a little bit thicker here by adding a bead. It's so pretty. What I'm going to do, make it a little bit wearable, well, a little bit more wearable for JJ, is to secure everything down. So I'm going to add a little bit of glass rose underneath anything that's high. So we're going to go underneath those loops there. These loops we've already done, they're quite flat. So the top loops will be the loops that are sitting high, need a little bit of support under there with that glass rose. You can use clear as well. I'm going to add a little bit in here. Just so I know these loops will last. So you're just giving them a little bit more support. I'm going to put a tiny bit in here, like I say, anything that's high. I don't mean like, you know, we're all getting high. Can you get your scissors in? Which one is it there?
No, the other one.
It fits! The ring, it fits! Fit for a queen. Or princess.
Princess.
Let's put a bit of oil on now. This is dry.
Bish bash bow.
Oh yeah, I like that one, Jay. Bish bash bow, see you in a mo. So there you are, guys. That's how to create a Japanese style, chunky, gorgeous, delicious bow. Mm-hmm. Fit for JJ. She's princess, obviously. We all know this. Don't forget the products that I've used today will be listed below as always. Check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I will see you guys in the next video. So please keep watching. Bye bye. Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to sculpt a nail out in one bead, and we are also going to do a 3D flower. It's not a flower, I'm chatting rubbish. It's a bow.